Namaste dosto, welcome to my little world. This is me, Rishika. So do you also want to learn English? Well, congratulations then, because this video is filled with all the tips that I have used to learn English to understand and to speak fluently. So this video is going to help you to first understand English, which is not that difficult if you're an Indian, and second, to speak English fluently, which is kind of tricky, but the tips used in this video, you are going to get your English game at a different level. So I don't want to waste a lot of time, and let's directly get into the first tip. And just know that practice is the key. Consistency is the key. The more consistent you are, the more easily you are going to learn English. So let's start with the number one tip, that is to watch in English. Pretty obvious, isn't it? So everything you watch, try to watch it in English. Like if you're watching a cartoon, turn it into English. If you're watching Avengers Hindi dubbed, turn it into English and see with the caption. And yes, captions are so important. So if you are seeing and listening the same thing at the same time, then it becomes a lot easier for your mind to process the information, and also you will be able to get a better understanding of the thing when you will see it. Like if you're not able to understand a word, let's say whining, you're not able to understand what whining is, but you are seeing on the television screen that someone is complaining in an annoyed and crying manner, then you suddenly get that, oh, maybe this is whining. This is how whining is. Yes. So this is the benefit of watching and listening in English, and also it will help you to improve your vocabulary, and once you are having some words, then you will be able to speak it, like framing it in a sentence and stuff. So make sure you are firstly getting the input in English with captions. Captions are so important, just don't forget them. Now it's time for the second tip, which will help you to become Shakespeare, is to talk to yourself. Now I know this is stupid and you will look as stupid while doing that, but this is just a magic. You know, when you're starting out, you're speaking English, you're not that confident, and to be honest, you don't speak right. 90% of the thing that you speak is wrong, having grammatical mistakes or pronunciation mistake or something like this. So if you have someone who will listen to you patiently and who will tell you where you are lacking or what is wrong in a manner that will encourage you, then that is a blessing. Then speak with the person in English. But if you're just starting out, then talk to yourself, because at that moment you need not to be confident. You just have to talk to yourself, and you can talk like a daily conversation, like two friends talk. Like you can talk to yourself like, how are you doing? I'm doing fine. What about you? Yeah, I'm also doing fine. You know what happened? And then blah 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 blah. So you can just talk like you talk to a friend, or you can create an imaginary scenario in your face, like it's your cousin sister's wedding, whom you like so much, who was your favorite, and she is getting married, and you have to give a speech kind of thing in English. So how will you do that? So just give her a speech, and you don't have to research a lot, just say what's in your mind. Just say whatever is in your mind, like if it's right, if it's wrong, nobody cares, because you're talking to yourself. And what will happen? Slowly, slowly, you will become confident and comfortable in speaking to yourself. And also, you will, when you are speaking something, you will feel that you are lacking, then you will search for it. You will find either alternatives, or you will find it in English. So this will improve A, your fluency, B, your vocabulary, and third, your confidence, or C, your confidence. Yeah, A, B, C. Yeah, your confidence. So the third tip is to think in English. Well, this is easy, believe me. So our mind produces like 50,000 thoughts per day. So we are going to take these thoughts to our advantage. So whenever you're thinking about something, like overthinking on stuff, well, you shouldn't overthink, obviously. But if you're thinking about something, then think it in English. Like you're thinking that, जब मैं वहाँ थी तो उसने ऐसा बोला. So we just think like, when I was there, she was speaking like this, or she spoke like this. So first you think in Hindi, then you convert it in English, and then let it stay in your mind. Don't speak it loud. So these are two different exercises. Talk to yourself by speaking loud, and think in English. So when you are thinking in English, what happens? Your brain becomes familiar with thinking in English. So just try to understand. So your brain becomes familiar, and usually it will become a habit of yours to think in English. For me, like now, I usually think in English, and rarely I do in Hindi or any other language. Though I don't know any other language actually, except French and Spanish, but that's not the point. Think in English. What think in English will do is that it will help you to fasten at the process of translation, and slowly with practice you wouldn't even need to translate. Yeah, so these are the tiny tips which will take you to your goals very soon. But now moving on to some more tips which will help you to understand and learn English. So the number 4 tip is to read in English. Obviously you saw it coming beforehand, didn't you? Me and not talking about book, well that's impossible. So reading in English is obviously a great way to push your mind to think in English. So start reading any book in English. But here I'm specifically talking about books related to English, which are related to English, like learn to translate in English or speak English in 30 days and stuff like that. Because these books import so much knowledge. So for me, I actually never really tried books because consistency issue. I never remained consistent so much. So I started, but I left it in midway or in the starting. I never really completed one. But if you do that, I bet you it will help you. Books import so much knowledge, and the thing is, you wouldn't even notice how much you have gained until you finish the book. So now the number 5th tip is a cheat tip, and before I tell you the tip, I'm giving you the disclaimer that I'm not saying or telling you that this is right or wrong. This is just out of my experience, so I really like this tip. It helped me a lot. So if you do not like this, move on. I'm not forcing you to accept it. It's my experience and I feel like sharing it will help you. So the 5th tip is a kind of cheat tip which I actually use till this day. And that is to fake your expertise. But for me, whenever I feel like I'm speaking something incorrect, I do either of these two things. A, I push my mind to process the right thing, and if I know the right thing, then I speak quickly the right thing before anyone else can. And B, if I don't know what is the right thing, I either move on without faking, like without showing that I have done something wrong or I have spoken something wrong, or if I'm standing with my loved ones or friends and family which I know who will not make fun of me, I just ask them what the correct thing could have been. So in this way, I'm protecting myself from getting embarrassed and also learning what the right thing is. So just so you know, learning English or learning any language or learning anything is a journey. And all the journey comes with some ups and downs. So there might be the moment when you will speak so confidently and you are so proud of yourself, then pat your back and move on to learning some more. And there will be times when you will feel embarrassed, when you have been made fun of, or you're just feeling embarrassed in yourself because you couldn't speak. Then also pat your back and move on to learning something more. Somebody laughed at you in front of some people or they made fun of you, just take it as a motivation to show them how amazing you are. Well, obviously these are not all the things that someone do to learn English, but this is the main thing which I use to learn English, and I really hope this will help you. One more thing which I want to mention is that you can learn English from apps. There are tons of apps. Well, I didn't use one, so I don't know. Well, I'm learning different languages. I'm learning Spanish right now, and that I'm learning from Duolingo. This app teaches English as well, so you can try that on. In my opinion, this is the best app I've ever used to learn a language. And while I'm learning Spanish, you can learn English. And this is amazing. So thank you so much for watching the video, guys. I really hope this video helped you. These were some of the tips which will help you to get closer to your goal. But make sure you are practicing and being consistent, because at the end, only thing that matters is how badly you want it. Love you. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.